Today we're going to build the VEX Robotics Catapult. Let's get started. For the first step, you're going to need a 2x12 beam and 3 1x1 pins. You can count the holes on your part to make sure you have the correct beam. Simply take your 1x1 pins and snap them into the holes as shown in the instructions. Now, take a 1x2 pin and insert the short end into the hole just above one of your previous pins, like it's shown in the instructions. Now, take two connectors and snap them on to your previous assembly. Make sure you push the connectors all the way down so that it's fully installed. Next, insert 4 1x1 pins into your beam in the position shown. You can see that I'm leaving one set of holes empty in between these pins and the connector I installed previously. Now, take a 2x10 beam and snap it onto your previous assembly onto those 1x1 connector pins. Make sure all four pins snap into the 2x10 connector beam. In this next step, you're going to take a standoff connector, an end standoff connector, and a standoff with four cavities in it and put them together like this. Make sure you get the correct standoff. You can check it based on your instructions to make sure you have the right length. In the next step, you're going to take a standoff end connector and connect it onto your previous assembly using 2 1x1 pins. Simply snap the 1x1 pin into the end of your previous assembly, then attach the standoff end connector, then take another 1x1 pin and put it into the side of the piece you just attached, so it looks something like this. Now, snap on a 3x5 beam to your previous assembly. You should install it in the hole in the center of the short side. Now, install 2 0x3 pins onto your 3x5 beam. The first one goes in the hole at the end, and it goes all the way in. You should hear three clicks as it fully installs. The second one goes in the second hole away from the short side and should only go in part of the way. You should hear two clicks as it installs. It should look like this when it's in the correct position. Now, combine the two assemblies from the previous step. Snap your 0x3 pin into the center hole at the junction of your 2x10 and 2x12 beams. In the next step, we're going to install two single cavity long standoffs into our previous assembly. These should snap into the first two open holes above these other pins that you've installed. They should look something like that. The next step, you assemble a 2x3 beam, a ball cradle, and a 3-cavity long standoff. Make sure you get the right length standoff from your instructions. The standoff goes in the upper right corner of your 2x3 beam, and the ball cradle snaps onto the bottom. Make sure you install it in the correct orientation. Now, mount your ball cradle assembly onto the back of the tower. This goes on the side opposite the lever arm that you put on before. It should snap in the open holes just above where you installed those two standoffs. Now, it's time to install your tires onto your sweet rims. Each tire has a little rubber notch inside it that matches up with a notch on the rim. Make sure when you press it on, these align correctly. That'll make sure your wheels turn smoothly when you're rolling your catapult around. Repeat this four times for all four of your tires. Now, take a plastic cap shaft and install it into your wheel. Each of these shafts has a nub on one side. Make sure that the nub is sticking up when you press it into your wheel. After it's installed, the shaft should be pressed all the way in, such that the nub is inside the tire here. Put one shaft spacer on your plastic shaft. Install your wheel into your previous assembly on the same side as your ball cradle. Once your wheel is fully installed, put a shaft collar on the end to keep it from coming off. You may need to brace a finger inside your wheel against the nub on the shaft to hold it in place as you press on your shaft collar. Now, on the same side as your wheel, install a 0x3 pin all the way in. This should go through the hole just next to the connector on the opposite end of the assembly from where your wheel is. Press it three clicks in so it goes all the way in like this. Next, install a shaft spacer on the pin you just installed. It should click on once. Don't put it all the way on, just make it come on so that it sticks on just past the end. Now, install the rear wheel in the same manner as before. Take a capped shaft and put it through your wheel. Add a shaft spacer to that same axle. Install your wheel such that it goes through the connector. Then, while bracing a finger against the cap on the shaft, install a shaft collar to keep the thing from falling apart. Now it's time to build the mechanism that'll wind back your catapult. Take the sprocket that comes in your kit, the long metal shaft that comes in your kit, make sure you use the long one, and a shaft collar, and assemble them like it shows in the instructions. First, press the shaft collar on a little bit down the shaft, and then install the sprocket. Now, let's install this axle into your main assembly. It should go in the second open hole over from the tower upright. You should insert it such that the sprocket is underneath your pivot arm. Once it's installed, take a shaft collar and put it on the back side of the axle to hold the entire assembly together. Press the two shaft collars together so the axle can't come out. Now, take a 2x3 beam and snap onto the two standoffs you attached to your tower before. You want the short side pointed towards the back of the assembly and down. Next, attach two cavity standoffs onto the side of your tower. The first one should go in the hole just above the blue ball cradle. The second one should go two holes above that. It should look like this. Now, install a black shaft cap and a 1x1 pin at the top of your 2x10 beam. Next, we need to install the rubber band, which will hold your ratcheting arm down. Loop the rubber band around the pin that you previously installed, and then wrap the rubber band around the shaft and loop it over the top of the other pin that you have a shaft collar on. Once it's in place, you should be able to spring load the pivot arm up, and the rubber band will pull it back down. Now, install a 1x12 beam to brace your tower. This goes from the 1x1 pin at the back of your catapult to the 1x1 pin at the top of your tower. When you snap it in, you'll note that you're not installing it at the end, you're one hole back from the end of the 1x12 beam. Next, install a 1x3 beam onto the standoffs you previously installed in your tower. Next, we need to install the winding string in your pulley drum. Each of these strings has a black connector on the end of it. Take one of these connectors and insert it through the hole in the side of your pulley. Once it's in, align it so that the hole in the center of the black connector lines up with the hole in the center of the blue pulley. To make it easier to work with, it might be easier at this point to wind the string around the pulley drum. Now, install your pulley onto the axle you previously have on your assembly. Make sure you line up the square hole in the pulley with the square axle. You don't need to slide it all the way on, get it about halfway down. Now it's time to start building the other side of your catapult. Start with a 2x12 beam and 3 1x1 pins. Snap them in the holes as the instruction shows. Now, take a 1x2 pin and insert it into your 2x12 beam. Next, take two connectors and install them onto the pins you previously installed. Make sure you snap them all the way down so that they're in place against the 2x12 beam. Insert four pins into place to mount your upright tower. Then, just like before, install your 2x10 beam as the upright. Make sure it snaps on with all four pins. Now, install a wheel, following the same method used before. Take a capped shaft, insert it in your wheel, add a shaft spacer, insert it through your assembly in the proper location, and then, while holding your finger against the shaft cap, press on a shaft collar to hold the whole thing together. Repeat this one more time for your fourth wheel. Take a cap shaft, insert it in your wheel, add a shaft spacer, install it in the proper location, and while bracing the cap of the shaft with your finger, install a shaft collar. Now, install the hardware on your upright. Just like before, you're going to put a black shaft cap in one of the upper corners, and a 1x1 pin in the other. Now, leave two open holes and install one two-cavity standoff. Leave another open hole and then install another two-cavity standoff. Take a look at your instructions if you have trouble understanding which hole which parts go in. Install the diagonal brace just like you did on the other side. Snap it into the hole at the bottom corner here, and the second hole from the end at the top of your upright. Now it's time to install your cross bracing that'll go between the two halves of your catapult. Take the longest standoff you have in your kit and insert into the hole right at the end next to the connector at the back. Next, install two standoffs at the top of your tower. If you have trouble identifying the length, take a look at your instructions and measure them appropriately. These standoffs snap into the top hole of your diagonal and into the black shaft cap. Next, install a 1x3 beam on the two short standoffs on the side of your upright. Now, it's time to take the two halves of your catapult and connect them together. An easy way to do this is take a look at where your long standoff is attached on the bottom. Make sure this one goes into the same hole on the opposite side. Likewise, these two standoffs at the top of the tower go into the holes on the other side. When you connect those together, make sure your axle threads through the correct hole on the other side. It may take a little work to make sure you get everything lined up, but once you're all set, it should just snap together. Now it's time to attach the front and rear chassis braces. These are 2x6 beams and snap into the connectors that you have on either side of your chassis. Put one on the front and one on the back. Make sure all four pins snap into place. Now, we need to build our catapult arm. We're going to start by taking one angled beam and four 2x2 pins. You want to install the 2x2 pins in the outside four holes and make sure they're fully inserted. So you should hear two clicks. One, two. One, two. Like this. Now, take another angled beam and snap it on to the long side of the pins, not the short side, the long side. Make sure all four pins go into the holes and snap it together so that both beams are up against each other. Now we're going to add connectors on either side of this assembly. Take the connector and make sure you attach it in the correct orientation, and then snap an additional connector onto the other side. Again, make sure these connectors are in the same orientation you see here and in your instructions. Next, attach part of your catapult arm. This snaps onto one side of the pins that are exposed on your previous assembly. Use the two holes at the very end. Next, attach three standoffs on your arm. Leave one empty hole and then put your first standoff. Then put your second standoff. And then put your third standoff all the way at the end. Now, we're going to build the catapult hard stop. Take a T-piece and a 2x2 pin. Insert the 2x2 pin in the bottom hole such that it's fully inserted, two clicks in. Then take a 1x1 pin and put it in the top center hole, like this. Now take a second T-piece and install it on the same side as the 1x1 pin and the longer section of the 2x2 pin. Now install your hard stop on your catapult arm in the hole just offset from the center towards the bottom. To ensure maximum performance of your catapult, pre-stretch your rubber bands. Next, complete your catapult arm by hooking two rubber bands over the standoff at the bottom edge of the arm. Then take an additional 1x10 beam and snap it in place, making sure you engage it with all three standoffs and all three white pins. Make sure each are snapped into position. Now, build your catapult cup by taking these blue cup sections and attaching them to the connectors at the top of your catapult arm. Next, we're going to install our catapult arm into our catapult using our shaft that's left. To start, we want to install the shaft partway into the side that doesn't have the ball cradle installed. Slide the shaft in such that it's centered on the 1x3 beam that's already in here. Make sure it's not sticking out into the middle. Next, take your catapult arm and slide it into position such that the fourth hole from the bottom is aligned with your shaft. Then push your shaft all the way through until it's fully inside. Once you're done, you should be able to pivot your catapult arm and have the shaft stay in place. Take a second to make sure that you put your shaft through the fourth hole from the bottom of the catapult arm. The first hole has the standoff, then there should be two empty holes, and then you should have a hole with the shaft going through it. Next, we need to build our second ball cradle. This is the mirror image of the one we already built. Use a 2x3 plate, a blue ball cradle piece, and a standoff. Attach them like the instructions shows. Make sure you snap the ball cradle into the correct orientation and try not to build it backwards or upside down. Next, install your ball cradle onto your catapult. You can align it by taking this standoff and making sure it's pointed at the end of your shaft that you installed previously. When it's installed, the standoff will hold the shaft in place and keep it from wiggling out. Next, we're going to take our rope and attach it to our catapult arm so that we can winch it back. Before we do that, we should probably take our hard stop and tilt it down out of the way so it's at the bottom of the arm. Next, we should take this opportunity to make sure our pulley is centered in the middle of our catapult. Now, unwind the string from around your pulley and take the end of the string and thread it up in between the two standoffs in the middle of your catapult arm. Once it's threaded through, take a 1x2 pin and insert it all the way through the black connector at the end of the string. This will keep the connector from sliding back in between the two standoffs. Now, when you pull on the arm, it'll pull down the when you pull on the string, it'll pull down the catapult arm. Now, we need to attach two short standoffs to the back of the catapult. These will be used later for attaching rubber bands. They go in the middle row of holes all the way at the ends. Snap them into place like this. Next, we need to stretch our rubber bands into position. To make it easier, hold your catapult arm all the way at the top of its motion. Now, flip it upside down, reach inside the chassis, and pull the rubber bands through the bottom. You're going to stretch one of them across the axle with the pulley on it and hook it on the standoff that's at the back of your catapult. Do the same thing for your other rubber band, hooking it onto the other standoff on the other side of the back bumper. Now, just make sure that the rubber bands don't get in the way of any of the motion components in the base. Keep them clear of the pulley and the ratchet mechanism. At this point, do a double check to make sure your rubber bands work correctly. Pull your catapult arm back by your hand and make sure it feels like they're stretching. Next, take a 1x5 beam and snap it onto the standoffs to hold your rubber bands in place. Once this beam is installed, the rubber bands shouldn't be able to come off of those standoffs where they're installed. For the last step in your build, attach your hand crank. You should have a little bit of shaft sticking out on one side of your catapult. Align the square hole in the crank such that it goes onto the shaft. Now you're ready to fire. Simply turn your catapult crank to winch back the catapult arm. When it's at the bottom of motion, load one of the included balls. This lever at the back of your catapult will release the ratchet and fire the mechanism. You can store additional ammunition in the ball cradles on the side of your catapult. That's it. Hope you had fun.